Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. There are many ways to make watermarks in Photoshop, however, I'm going to show you what I think is the most effective. For this example, we'll use text. However, if you want to transform a logo or an image into a watermark, make sure it's black on a white background, and then remove the background. I covered how to do this in my tutorial showing how to make PNG files. I provided its link located in the video's description. Open a photo you'd like to place a watermark onto. Open your horizontal type tool and choose a font that's easy to read. I'm using Arial Regular. I'll choose a size of 80 points, sharp, and center alignment. Click on the color box and for the brightness, type in 50%. This gives us a medium gray color. Then click OK or press Enter or Return. Type out your text. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. I'll leave room on the left to place a copyright symbol next to it. Click on the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Custom Shape tool and choose Pixels. If you're working on CS5 or earlier, the pixels icon is here. Open your shape preset icons. If you don't see the copyright symbol, click the gear icon and click Reset Shapes. Then click OK. Click the symbol and click the gear icon at the top. Tick Define Proportions and check From Center. Place your cursor to the left of your text and drag out the symbol. Open your Move tool and drag it so it's centered next to your text. Merge the two layers by shift-clicking on the text to highlight both layers and then pressing Ctrl or Command E. Double-click on it to open its layer style window. Click Bevel and Emboss. The style is outer bevel. The technique is chisel hard, the depth is 50%, the direction is up, and the size is 5 pixels. Uncheck global light. Make the angle 145 degrees and the altitude 26 degrees. Make the highlight opacity 100% and the shadow opacity 100%. Make the highlight blend mode normal as well as the shadow blend mode. Check Contour, and then click OK. Click the icon at the upper right corner of the Layers panel, and click Convert to Smart Object. I'll show you why we're doing this in a minute. To open the Smart Object, double-click the thumbnail. When you see this message, click OK. Reduce the fill to 50%. Go to the tab of the Smart Object, and click the small box with the X in it to close it. When you see this message, click Yes to save the changes. Reduce the opacity to taste. I'll reduce it to 75%. I'll show you why we made it into a smart object. First, let's make a copy of the watermark by pressing Ctrl or Command J. Open your Transform tool by pressing Ctrl or Command T. To move it, click inside the transform and drag it to a new location. To enlarge or reduce its size, go to a corner and press and hold Shift as you drag it out or in. Then, press Enter or Return to accept it. Notice that the bevel and emboss layer style reduced in size with the text. If we didn't convert the text into a smart object, the bevel and emboss layer style would have kept its original pixel size. The watermark is readable over black, white, and grays. If you like to make it more transparent, simply reduce its opacity. For now, I'll put the opacity back to 75%. Once you're happy with your watermark, to save it, hide all the other layers, and go to Image and Trim. As long as the Trim Away boxes are checked, it doesn't matter which option you choose for based on. Then, click OK. Go to File and Save As. Name your file and save it as a PNG or PNG file. Save it to a location in your computer where you can easily find it, and then click Save. When the PNG options appear, I generally click None for both the compression and interlace. I explain these settings in depth in my tutorial about PNG files. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.